Oh, sorry, you're dead. I just think of how ridiculous I must look right now.
Hey guys, this is Austin. Is the Microsoft HoloLens the future? While there's been a lot of talk about virtual reality headsets, the HoloLens is something a little different. You're able to walk around and fully interact with the world with straight Minority Report stuff, like floating web pages and holograms. For a developer kit, it actually comes with a pretty solid unboxing experience. Open it up, and you'll see the HoloLens comes with a cool carrying case. Inside, though, is where the real magic is. What really jumps out at me is just how polished the HoloLens already feels. Compared to early VR headsets like Oculus, this looks like a product you could buy today, which I guess shouldn't be a huge surprise coming from a company like Microsoft. The crazy thing is, this is fully untethered. There's no need to be attached to a PC to handle stuff like rendering, or needing to set up a bunch of sensors around your room. There's some serious power inside too, but Microsoft is still being very vague about what actually makes it all work. There's some custom silicon inside, but it seems like a lot of the heavy lifting is being handled by the sensors. It doesn't get warm or even uncomfortable after wearing it for a while, and the battery will last around 3 hours, which is impressive for what's essentially a full holographic computer that lives on your face. Put the HoloLens on, run a quick scan of the room, and you're ready to go. The thing that makes the HoloLens special is the holographic display. This isn't like a traditional screen, as it's fully transparent until there's something to actually see. Not only does this make interacting with the real world dead simple since your vision isn't obscured, but it also means the holograms can be incredibly sharp. What really blew me away is the tracking. It's almost perfect. Walk around a room, move around as much as you want, it doesn't matter. If you put a browser window against a wall, it's not going anywhere, which can actually lead to funny problems, like forgetting where you put something in real space. It's easy to imagine a desk setup where you're using the HoloLens, and you have different browser windows and research projects on your desk, on the wall in front of you. This is really cool stuff. A lot of what makes this special comes down to this being something that adds to your vision, not replacing it altogether. You can still see everything around you and talk with people, but there might just be aliens flying around the room or a browser tab on the wall behind them. The biggest learning curve is control. The HoloLens relies on a couple gestures, like clicking with one finger and opening your hand to pull up a menu. These work, but it can get a little tiring to constantly have your hand held out in front of you to select things. What's interesting is that the screen doesn't work off a traditional resolution, since it's measured in rays of light, but there's clearly more detail on the HoloLens than any VR headset I've ever tried. Even small text from across the room is readable, which is something not even the recording can fully get across. The biggest issue is the field of view. It's fairly small.
So I'm recording with this super awesome iPhone mount. So this is actually pretty close to what you would see through the HoloLens. So you can see it looks nice and the tracking's good, however, for example, if I look at something like this, the field of view is not enormous. So you can see that it's still a little bit transparent, right? So you can kind of like see behind that window and everything. The field of view, it's decent enough, and especially with things that are kind of transparent like that, like this looks fine, this looks fine. It's only when you get to bigger, more complex things that you really realize that it's a little bit lacking.
There's also some color shifting you can notice in the screen, especially in pure white areas, but again, it's really not that bad. It's clear that Microsoft focused on the hard stuff, like making the tracking work and fitting all of this hardware inside a fully portable headset. The HoloLens really is something you have to try to fully appreciate. With the hardware already being so polished, the biggest thing holding it back seems to be getting developers to actually create software for it. But since it's running a version of Windows 10, it's not too crazy to port stuff over, and since this is one of the very first developer kits, it's just going to take time. I've got to give a huge shout out to my friends Adam and Glenn from Master of Shapes for letting me borrow their HoloLens and shoot a video. They're awesome, and so is the HoloLens. This is absolutely the future. So what do you guys think about the HoloLens? Let me know in the comments below, and I will catch you in the next one.